Surprise, bitch, clickbait video. No, I'm just kidding, please don't leave. But on a realer note, this video is gonna be more of a JB4 review, more than a comparison between different tunes for the Mark 7 GTIs. So if you don't know already, JB4 is made by this company called Berger Motorsports, and they specialize in a bunch of different performance parts as well, such as cold air intakes, catch cans, and stuff like that. But what they're really known for is their power module called the JB4, and they're really popular in the BMW world, but they also make parts for different cars as well. For example, this instance, Volkswagens, Mark 7s, but also they make parts for like Mini Coopers, Lexuses, Hondas, and some other companies as well. And in this case, coming from a Volkswagen Mark 7 perspective, JB4 is one of the easiest, quickest, and safest ways to make more power out of the car. And I'll explain what I mean later when I say safest. And to try to explain what a JB4 is without getting too technical and getting into all the boring details of it, for those who are interested, you can probably read it on their website. But what it essentially is, it's a piggyback plug and play tune. And the reason I put tune in quotation marks is because it's kind of a tune, but it's also not really.
So to my understanding of how it works is basically the JB4 tricks the car's ECU to thinking that it's underperforming. So then the car tries to overcompensate for that underperformance. And by doing so, it kind of turns up the boost, more fuel, and tries to maintain that level of performance that it was tuned for from the factory. But in reality, your car was actually doing fine, but then it still turns up the boost and the fuel and other metrics of the car's performance, and therefore you're getting more power. So it's not really like a tune where you're remapping the whole ECU and changing a bunch of different aspects in the car's computer and stuff like that. Instead, you're kind of just, it's kind of like a backdoor kind of just tricking the car into giving you more power naturally. If that makes sense, that's like the easiest way that I can think of to put it. So for the Mark 7 GTIs, the JB4 is advertised to give it 35 more wheel horsepower and 40 more torque. So now I kind of want to just go over the pros and cons of the JB4 after using it for about a year or so, I believe. Pros: the first thing I really liked about it was that it was cheap. And when I say cheap, I mean cheap when compared to an actual tune. For example, like an APR stage one tune, a JB4 is only like $430 compared to APR stage one tune, which is like $700. And on top of that $700, you have to pay a tuning shop for like time and labor to install it for you. But JB4 is only like $430 online from their website, shipped to your door, and you kind of just install it yourself at home. The next thing I really like about it, and this was also a main reason why I got a JB4 rather than the actual tune, is that it's undetectable by dealerships. And this is also the reason why I said it was safe earlier. So a traditional tune, what it does is it reflashes your whole car's ECU. And people have told me that even if you were to flash your car back to stock, some dealerships have a way of finding out how many times the ECU was flashed, or if it was flashed at all. And it's kind of up to them if they wanna deny you warranty work or flag your car for a TD1. Whereas a JB4, all you really gotta do is just unplug all its sensors and that's about it. You're not really permanently changing anything in the computer's ECU. Like, you're not rewriting the code, you're not moving things around or anything like that. So the dealership really has no way to tell if it was like messed with or change or anything, because you're not changing anything. You're kind of just intercepting signals of the car. So yeah, the dealership really has no way to tell that is mess with. That's just what I've gathered from the Mark 7 community, that we've all agreed upon that the JB4 is not detectable by dealerships, and many people have just taken their JB4s off and still gotten warranty work with it fine. The next thing I really like about it is that it's a physical thing that you can resell. Let's say, for example, you have a JB4 on, and then maybe after your warranty expires, you're like, fuck it, I'm gonna go an actual tune now, stage one, stage two. You can actually just take a JB4 off and sell it. And what I've seen so far, like, JB4s don't really depreciate. Like, you buy it for around $400 or something, and maybe you'll get back like $375, $350, and that's like really low. I know people that sell it for like $400. So it's something they can resell, unlike a tune where it's kind of like you and your car and kind of that's it. Whereas the GB4, you know, you can take it off, resell it, and then if you ever choose to go a different route, you're kind of getting majority of your money back. The next great thing about it is that it's customizable and it's stackable with the tune. The GB4 comes with different maps that you can play with. Their maps 1 and 2 are like the default maps from the factory, and in their map 6 is like the fully customizable map that people use to get a pro tune, customized tune. What I also know is that people use map 6 and they kind of stack you with an actual tune. For example, they put an IS-38 in the GTI, and then they stack it with Watermath, and they also put a GB4 on top of it to make even more power.
3, 2, 1!
Another thing I really like about it is that it offers this Bluetooth kit for the GB4, and what it does is it connects your phone via Bluetooth to GB4, and then you can monitor like a bunch of different vehicle measurements, for example, boost, RPM, oil temperature, air fuel ratio, and a bunch of different measurements for it. And you can even update the firmware and change maps all through your phone. And although the Bluetooth kit has like a bunch of cool features, it kind of helped me segue into this next part of this video, which is the cons of the GB4. And one of the main cons, the main things I don't like about it, is that the Bluetooth kit is like an additional $140-$150. And then on top of that, you also have to buy the app for iPhone or Android for an additional $28. And that's just like, come on, man. At this point, like, you're just trying to charge as much as you can. Now, if you don't want to pay for the Bluetooth kit, you can always get the data cable, but it's also an additional $35. And then with that, you gotta open up the GB4 box every time, connect it to a laptop, and then do the updates and map changes from there. It's kind of a hassle, but I guess it's way cheaper than paying $170 for the app and the Bluetooth kit itself. So yeah, I don't like the cost of that Bluetooth kit. And then the only other thing I don't like about the GB4 is that it doesn't make as much power as an actual tune. People have said if you get a pro tune right and stuff like that, it has the potential to make as much power as a stage 1 tune. But stage 2, the GB4 just can't reach that power. And this is from, you know, from a Mark 7 GTI perspective, not from like the JB4s for the BMW. I don't know much about that, but from a Mark 7 GTI perspective, it doesn't make as much power as an actual tune. So there's that. And that about wraps up this video. To reiterate, JB4 is one of the easiest, quickest way, and safest way to make more power from your car. And this is not a sponsored video. They did not sponsor me. I had to pay for the JB4 myself, sadly. But if you have any questions about it or comments, put them in the description, DM me, and I'll try my best to answer them. Although the Berger Motorsports customer service team is also pretty good. So yeah, catch you guys in the next